else wake up crying?
Pretty much.
It's a very emotional day.
That's what I was doing yesterday.
Growing up, there was no better friend to escape reality with. I can do this. As an adult, when reality hit its hardest, she was always there to help me cage the sadness with poetry and painting. From the beginning, I instantly saw a lifelong friend.
You don't want to come sit and join us?
Me?
You got Bryce Beatty over here?
Bryce Beatty.
I was in awe of her creative expression. Her weird complemented my weird. When I moved to California without her, it was one of the most painful days, but Operation Get My Buddy to Cali was in full swing. I did feel awful pulling her away from her family in Texas, but deep down, I felt she was meant for a larger life and hopefully a deserving companion. So when I met Carlos and witnessed how he looked at Jessica, I knew his admiration was genuine because, hey, that's how I always looked at her. Then after a few weeks together, them, not me, but them, I saw him defend Jessica against someone being unjust to her. And I felt this is all too surreal. I was always the chicken hawk to anyone giving my friend crap. But there he stood, a full-blown, robust rooster, ready to peck out someone's eyes. Oh, not that Jessica can't hold her own. Oh no, we're from Texas, we can hold our own. It's just that a queen shouldn't ever have to lift a finger, and I'm so glad she found her king.
Hello, I got something for Jess.
Jess, it's
hi.
No, it's not a stripper.
Well, hi, my name is Alejandro. Not that much of many words, but same how it is. I met Jess in 08 on our second day with my wife at Disneyland. To get the approvals to date me, probably. But I saw they were sisters, always together, always everywhere, always drinking together. Only one of them can't handle, that's my wife. Then later on, she brought Carlos to my parents' house one day. Even though that we lived in the same neighborhood, he knew who I was, but not completely. I was the asshole doing the burnouts, but it's a small world. Two girls from Texas come to California, married two guys from LA with the same last name. And I know Carlos loves her a lot. He looks at her, that's his queen. That's his wife now. Hey, I love you guys. You're a brother, you're a sister. And I always take care of you guys. You guys take care of each other. And I always love you guys.
You're gonna make me cry.
All right. You're the only one for me. You're the love of my life. Love of my life, my forever soulmate. The one who shares everything that's important to me. And it was part of all my happiest dreams. You mean more to me than I could ever say. I'm gonna cry. I hate when I get like and my only wish on our wedding day is that I will always make you happy as you make me. Can't wait to marry my best friend, Jessica. Cut. No, I'm just kidding. That's awesome. Feel her, thank you.
He's the one and only love that I've been waiting for all my life. To finally meet. I can't express how much I am in love with you. And I can't wait for us to get married. In a few moments. I hope you like this present, and I'll see you in a few, Mrs. Gonzalez. Your future husband. Carlos. P.S. Let's do this.
Oh, nice.
From Jessica.
Awesome, thank you. Tell her thank you. A little pocket watch with the initials on it.
Oh, it's a locket.
Aww.
It says, till the end of time. C and J, and then our wedding day.
Aww. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous, it does not put on airs, it is not snobbish. Love is never rude, it is not self-seeking. It is not prone to anger, neither does it brood over injuries. Love does not rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices with the truth. There's no limit to love's forbearance, to its hope, its trust, its power to endure. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
It's my way to want to cry.
Jessica, Carlos, you come here in this beautiful place in the company of your family, your relatives, your friends, to say what are arguably some of the most solemn and the most serious words that you're ever going to speak in all your life. They are amongst the most solemn because in a few moments you make vows to your Creator. And when we do this in freedom and with clarity and presence of mind, those are words that touch our spirit and affect us beyond this life. So the words you're about to speak are solemn because you direct them to the one of whom the prophet Jeremiah wrote, knitted you together in your mother's womb.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
You feel like so special. Yeah.
Look at this crying mom over here.
The words you're about to speak are also very serious words because you're about to exchange a series of promises with each other. Promises that will take your two individual lives and place them on a common path and unite you both legally and socially for years and for decades yet to come. Love is found expressed in every human language, in every culture, in every age of human history. Love, therefore, is something integral to what it means to be a human being. But what precisely is love? I think in our time, the most common understanding of love is that love is a very powerful feeling, an emotion that we hold deep within our heart for someone else. But at the end of the day, love is much, much more than just a feeling. In fact, it comes down to a decision, a choice that we make in freedom to place another human being and their needs, their hopes, their dreams on par with, and oftentimes above, our own. Do you take Jessica for your lawful wife, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to have and to hold from this day forward, until death do you part? He's enthusiastic. This is good.
I do.
Jessica, do you take Carlos for your lawful husband, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to have and to hold from this day forward until death do you part?
I do.
Jessica, accept this ring as a symbol of my love and of my fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Carlos, accept this ring as a symbol of my love and of my fidelity. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Jessica, accept these coins as a symbol that we will work together for our home.
Carlos, I accept these coins as a symbol that both of our contributions will be respected and appreciated.
Jessica, accept this Bible and rosary as a symbol that we will work together for our spiritual development.
Carlos, I accept this Bible and rosary as a symbol that our home will be a house of prayer.
It is my privilege and my pleasure to present for the very first time the newly married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Gonzalez. God strengthen and deepen your mutual love. Amen. May the peace of God always be found in your minds and your hearts. Amen. May you be blessed with good and faithful friends who stand at your side both in the times of trial and of joy. Amen. And may you, like the holy prophets, be a voice for the voiceless, an advocate for the poor and the marginalized. May these give you welcome into the kingdom of justice, light, and peace at the conclusion of your life's journey. Amen. May Almighty God bless all here present, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.